Okay, so scientific notation, I'll just introduce the topic. Scientific notation, as you carry on through math and you do start studying science and kind of applied science, you might run into this notation. So it's basically another way of representing a number. Typically, you can represent numbers in decimal form, but they're not always very convenient, especially if you're trying to represent something which is extremely small or extremely big, and scientific notation can help out with that. So what is this scientific notation? We know decimals because we kind of study them since very early on. Scientific notation, it turns out that it has a very special form. So I'm going to write down an example for you, and maybe you've seen this before or not, and then I'm going to try to explain to you what it means. Every number can be represented, which is a decimal number, can be represented in this kind of powers of 10. Now, you know, what I wrote here isn't really anything extraordinary. So we have a leading number right here. So let's say, I put 2.5, it doesn't matter what it is. Then we're going to have a multiplication sign, and then we have a power of 10 raised to some exponent. So first, let me tell you some restrictions that the scientists, I didn't make this up, but scientists, I guess, made this notation, that they put on this. So the restrictions are that this number right here, which we actually call, it has a special name, funny name, it's called a mantissa. And I'm going to refer it to just as M. So the mantissa in scientific notation is always less than 10, but it has to be greater or equal to 1. And that is, we are assuming that the mantissa can actually be both positive or negative. So we take absolute value of the mantissa, all right? So that's what it can be. It has to be somewhere in between there. So it can be, for instance, both positive or negative. So if it's negative 2.5, as you know, if you take negative 2.5 and take the absolute value of that, that would be just 2.5, and it lies between this restriction. So the restriction is it has to be between 1 and 10, all right? Or between, if it's negative, then it's basically between negative 1 and then negative 10, okay, in that stream. Now, the other restriction is on the exponent. So the exponent right here that we see, it has to be an integer. So it is allowed to be anything that is an integer. So now integers are basically positive and negative, and it also includes zero. So what do these mean? Okay, so when you have these. Well, if you take, so if I would take this entire example and I would want to break it down, what this really means, let's assume that it's positive for the moment. What this means is that this would just simply be the following. So we would write this out in this way if we wanted to compute. But it's much more convenient, instead of these multiplications, to just simply write this as powers of 10, okay, with the exponent, then just start writing 10 and 10. Because imagine, you know, that exponent would have been 20. We don't want to be writing 20 tens, so we put it in this scientific notation and simply say, you know, 10 to whatever that exponent might be. Now, sometimes, okay, because I don't want you to think that these exponents are always positive. As I said, they can be integers. So if they're integers, well, then what can happen is, if they're positive, then they're just multiplying 10. How many times? Well, as many times as we have the exponent. Now, if we have 2.5, and let's say we had 10, now if the integer is negative, now what does this mean? So if you have this, what that means is actually, this doesn't mean that it's multiplying. This actually means that we're going to be dividing by 10, how many times? 3 times. So that negative that you see in the exponent actually tells us that we're doing division instead of multiplication. That's what we have. All right? And that's how this scientific notation kind of lies about. Now, of course, as a student, you might think, well, why the heck do I have to know another representation? But it is pretty useful as you keep studying. It pops up in chemistry, it'll pop up in health problems that you may run into, okay? Might pop up in physics, okay, depending on what you study. All right? So that's what I wanted you to take out of this video. So the important part is that you can represent pretty much any decimal that you have in this scientific notation. And remember that the mantissa has to be between 1 and 10. It's allowed to be 1, okay, but it has to be less than 10. So it's somewhere in between. And then the exponent on the power is always an integer. All right? Now, if you want to see some examples, for instance, converting from decimals to scientific notation and how to do that, I'll put up a link up above there for you. All right? So you can watch it if you like. Now, the other one, if you were given scientific notation and you wanted to convert it back to a decimal, how do you do that? I'll put up a link up above there, okay, for some examples if you like. All right, so thanks for watching. If you do have any questions, put them down in the comments, and then I'll follow up and put the results there, okay, for you. Bye, everybody.